This video is sponsored by Skillshare. Hey guys, my name is Vikas and welcome back to this brand new video. In this video, I'm going to create very simple and awesome looking title animation inside of DaVinci Resolve that you can call it frosted glass wipe effect. So without any further ado, let's take a new project and get started. Alright, so if you are new here, be sure to hit the subscribe button for more interesting videos, and let's do the basic setting first. So click on this setting button and set the size of this project 1920 by 1080, which is a full HD resolution, but you can select any different resolution from here. Now let's select a frame rate. So in this case, I am going with 30 frames per second, which is a normal frame rate, but if you want a smooth animation, then you can select this 60 frames per second and then click on save. Now I'm going to create this animation inside of this fusion page. So we have to take a new fusion composition. So just go to this media pool, right click on that, click on this new fusion composition. Let's call it fusion composition. And we have to set the duration maybe 3 seconds long, which is good enough for one text. Frame rate 30, click on create. Now just drag this fusion comp on the timeline, just like that, and then go to your fusion page. And here we have this media out node. So just drag this media out to the side for now. And let's take a background. So click on this background button to take a background on this flow window and just drag this background to the viewer. Now this is a black background, which is perfect. And now let's take a text. So click on this T icon to add a text node and just drag this text to the viewer. And here we have to type a text. And now you can select your favorite font style. So in this case, I am using the Century Gothic font style, which is my favorite font style. And of course, you can select any different font style that you want. And I'm going to set it to bold. And let's increase the size of this text. So I'm going to set the size maybe 0.26. And now I'm going to create a scale animation for the text. So just go to the end of this animation, right click on size, click on animate, and go back to very first frame of this animation, and let's increase the size a bit. So I'm going to set the size 0.27. And now we have a nice scale animation, as you can see. All right, and after that, we have to merge this text with the background. So what we have to do, we have to take a merge node first. So this is the merge icon. So just drag this merge on this flow window. And here we have four different points. So the yellow point is for background. The green point is for foreground. And this blue point is for effect mask. And this is the output. All right. So I'm going to use this black background as a background and the text as a foreground. So we have to connect this yellow background point with this background and green foreground point with this text. And just drag this merge one to the viewer, and after that we have to colorize this text. So select this text, let's scale it up a bit. So hold control and scroll up to zoom in, and then go to your setting tab, and here we have this property. So right now this is a solid color, so we have to change this solid to gradient color. And now we will get two different point for two different color. And now let's create a nice gradient color. So click on this first point, click on this color selection box. And here I'm going to use this light pink, hit OK. Click on this second point. For the second one, I'm going to go with this red color. Basically, we have to create a nice gradient color just like this. And before we proceed further, let me tell you this video is sponsored by Skillshare. Skillshare is an online learning community for creatives where millions come together to take the next step in their creative journey. Skillshare offers thousands of inspiring classes for creatives and curious people on the topic including illustration, design, photography, video, freelancing and more. Skillshare offer creative classes designed for real life and all the circumstances that comes with it. These lessons can help you to stay inspired, express yourself and introduce you to a community of millions. You can check out this digital poster design course on Skillshare by Tammy Cocker. In this 90-minute class, you will join designer and artist Tammy Cocker to learn his inspiring approach to combining image and type to create bold visual designs. Skillshare is also very affordable for everyone. It's less than $10 a month with an annual subscription. And the best thing is that the first 1000 people to use the link given in the description will get a free trial of a Skillshare premium membership. Just go to the link in the description and check this out. And after that, we have to add some effect. So hit Control or Shift plus a spacebar for search box and search for glow effect. So this is our glow. Hit add button and just drag this glow one to the viewer. And here we have this glow size. So I'm going to increase this glow size something around 150. And now let's increase this glow intensity. So right now the value is 0.8, so I'm going to set it to 0.9. And it's looking like this, as you can see. And after that, we have to add a blur effect. So hit Control plus a spacebar for search box and search for Gaussian blur. So this is our Gaussian blur effect. Hit add button, just drag this Gaussian blur to the viewer. And right now we have 0.4 value in horizontal strength and vertical strength. So let's increase this value, and I'm going to set this value 0.6 in horizontal and vertical strength both. And we will get this type of output. And after that, let's make it more realistic. So we have to attach a film grain effect. So hit Control plus a spacebar for search box and search for film grain. So this is our film grain node. Hit add button and just drag this film grain to the viewer. Let's drag this media out to the side for now. And here we have this frosted glass kind of effect. All right, and after that we have two different output. The first one is looking like this and the second one is looking like this. And I'm gonna merge both the outputs, so we have to take a new merge node. So click on this merge button to add a merge node. And again, we will get four different points. So I'm gonna use this film grain as a background. So we have to connect this yellow background point with this film grain. And I'm gonna use this output as a foreground. So we have to connect this green foreground point with this merge one output. And it's looking very weird. So hold Alt on the keyboard and add a junction. And let's arrange it like this. And now it's looking so much better. But this is an optional step. You can skip this step. And now just drag this merge two to the viewer. And after that, just go to media pool, right click on that, click on import media. And I'm gonna use this brush underscore one PNG file. Let's open it up and just drag this to the flow window. Hit F2 on the keyboard, call it brush. Hit okay. And let me tell you, I have given a link in the description for this brush. So just go to the link in the description and download this brush if you want. And after that, we have to attach a transform node with this brush. So select this brush, click on this transform node, and this transform is going to be the controller of this brush. So hit F2 on the keyboard, call it controller. Hit OK. And now I'm going to connect the output of this controller with this merge 2. Now let's arrange it and just drag this merge 2 to the viewer, and we will get this type of effect. Alright, now close this media pool, and now let's set this brush on this text just like that. And after that, let's animate this brush. So just go to on frame number 60, which is equal to 2 seconds according to 30 frame per second, and select this controller, right click on center, click on animate, and lock this position as it is. Go back to 1 second, so it should be on frame number 30. And let's drag this brush stroke outside of this frame. And now we will get this type of glass wipe kind of effect, as you can see. But this is a linear animation right now, so we have to make it a smoother. So just go to a spline window, check this option controller, click on fit, select this both keyframe. Hit S on the keyboard to smooth, or you can also click on this smooth button. Set the CTI at very beginning of this keyframe. Hold this handle and just drag it like this and create a nice smooth curve. just go to 5 frame forward in time, hold this handle as well and just drag it like this. Basically, we have to create a nice smooth curve for nice smooth animation and close this spline window. And now we have nice and smooth animation. Click on fit. All right, it's looking nice as you can see. And after that, we have to attach a color corrector node just after this main output. So select this merge 2, click on this color corrector, just drag this color corrector to the viewer, hit F2 on the keyboard to rename and let's call it color. Hit OK. And here you can control the color of this text by shifting this hue value. All right, and you can increase the gain value as well according to the color. So I'm gonna set this value 1.3. It's looking much more interesting as you can see. All right, and finally we have to create light flickering effect at the beginning of this animation. So select this text, go to this setting tab, go to very first frame, and here we have to animate the opacity. So just right click on opacity, click on animate and set this value 0. Go to 1 frame forward in time, set it to 1. Go to 1 frame forward in time, set this opacity to 0. Go to 2 frame forward in time, set this opacity to 1. All right, basically we have to create on off effect. And now just go to 1 frame forward, let's set this opacity to 0. Go to 1 frame forward again, set this opacity to 1. Go to 4-5 frame forward in time, add one more keyframe and lock this value. Go to 1 frame forward in time and let's down this value to 0. And finally, let's go to 1 frame forward in time and set this opacity to 1. And now we have light flickering kind of effect at the beginning of this animation. All right. And after that, we have to connect this media out with this main output. Just like this. And then go to your edit page. And here, let's do one more thing. Just go to timeline. Go to output blanking and select this option 2.40. And after that, we have cinematic aspect ratio for cinematic look. And now, if you want to create multiple text, then you have to select this fusion composition, hit Ctrl C on the keyboard, hit Ctrl V to paste, place the CTI on this second composition, go to fusion page, and here you can change the color first. So I'm going to use this color. You can adjust the gain value as well. So let's down the gain value 1 maybe. Maybe set this gain value 1.1. Now it's perfect. And you can change the text by selecting this text node. So select this text node and change the text from here. All right. And then go to the edit page. And here our text design is ready for render. All right, so just go to very first frame and let's take a look. All right, so it's looking awesome, and that's all for this tutorial guys. I hope you like it. If you like it, then hit the subscribe button, click on the bell icon to get notified when I will upload my new video. My name is Vikas and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye bye.